हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग. वेरी मॉडरेटली कोल्ड मॉर्निंग फ्रॉम गोवा. गोवा द वेदर इज़ वेरी हॉट, बट देन द मॉर्निंग स्टिल इज क्वाइट प्लेजेंट. एज यू नो, येस्टरडे वी स्पोक टू वेरियस लीडर्स टेकिंग पार्ट इन असेंबली इलेक्शंस. टुडे द पर्सन माई न्यू गेस्ट सिटिंग नेक्स्ट टू मी इज़ नन अदर दैन मिस्टर दिगंबर कामत, हु इज़ अ फॉर्मर चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ द स्टेट. And he's been, I think, one of the longest serving the MLAs from this constituency, yeah. Margaon, where we are sitting right now. We'll be talking about, you know, sort of, you know, what makes him so invincible in Margaon. But there are various other issues as well, which he has been part of in his capacity as the chief minister. Mr. Kamath, yesterday, last night, I mean, I saw your road shows or the door-to-door campaign yesterday. There was a very, very good turn-up, which is not unusual because you have enjoyed good popularity. But last night, I was witness to Aam Aadmi Party's Arvind Kejriwal's rally not far from your house. And a few thousand people had actually turned up. Are you nervous about that?
No, I'm not bothered about who contests against me, how many parties contest against me. Because I am confident, this is my seventh election. I have been winning six times from Margaon constituency. Every year, the parties come and say they vote for a change. People of Margaon ask them, why are you talking about a change? Tell us what you will do. They are not able to tell them what they will do. They only say they vote for a change. Whereas my approach to my voter is, I tell them what I have done. I said, if you wish that Digambar Kamath should represent you again, please ask your conscience and vote for me. Margaon people have full faith in me, and that is the reason I said I am permanently obliged to the Margaonkars for having elected them for the sixth time. I don't want to say thank you to them. I will remain under their obligation till my death.
And you, even when you were chief minister, this remained your residence in Margaon, right?
Even in the night I used to come here. I never stayed in the official residence. Because of my connect with the common man, my common people used to come early morning to meet me. After meeting them, I used to leave for Panji. That has been my speciality. My USP has been the accessibility to a poorest man in the state.
So, why do you think the party has not projected you as the chief minister candidate again this time?
Party's policy with respect to chief ministers, candidates is different in because they have their own system. They work under the certain these that after the election, MLAs will meet, decide, and then the party leadership in Delhi will take a call on it. That is why in 2007, when I was made the chief minister, I never expected that I will be the chief minister of the state. I never dreamt, to be frank. But party said, we have decided to make you the chief minister.
Okay, so that was post-poll, post-election
results. Post-election 2007.
Yeah. Okay. Now, one of the thorny issues, you know, that we have seen in this election campaign is your relationship with Goa Forward. Both the parties tried to build an alliance, anti-BJP coalition. It didn't happen. What went wrong?
Actually, I do not know. Some days back, I had written an article in some newspapers. In that, I clearly mentioned that the Congress is the principal opposition party in the state of Goa. Hence, it is the responsibility of the Congress party as the principal opposition to unite all the anti-BJP forces to defeat BJP in the state. This was my meaning of that article. And I felt that whoever is opposed to BJP should be roped in so that Congress becomes strong in the state and all the anti-forces, anti-BJP forces unite. Unfortunately, because this does not remain in hands of the local leaders, the leadership in Delhi and all, they are also part of it. And then what went wrong while holding negotiations, I really do not know. But in Margaon, during the last municipal elections, we came together, myself and Vijay Sardesai, we came together to keep BJP away from the municipal council. And we swept the municipal polls. In fact, he won 11 out of 11 in
that's
his constituency.
Forward.
And I won 7 out of 11 in my constituency. 18 seats were won out of 25. We have a chairperson of his group and a vice chairperson of my group.
So isn't that a common sense, you know, for the Delhi leadership that if you too can actually achieve so much, you know, at the ground level, at the local level. What could have happened if you had replicated the same formula, you know, across the state?
See, whenever I was called by the Delhi leadership to ask my opinion, I had given them the whatever was my view on that. That is there the matter.
And you stated that experiment to them.
I have told them everything as far as my views are concerned. Hmm. I'm met all the leaders in Delhi who had called me to give and ask my views, and I have told them, I have given them the example also.
So, you know, do you think it's going to hurt your poll prospects? Although they are only contesting in four and they've got fifth who is their sympathizer.
As far as Margaon is concerned, I don't get disturbed. Because I have full faith, as I said, in Margaonkars. Margaonkars have seen me grow in this city from my childhood.
But you're not a local leader, you're a state leader. You are a potential chief minister, future chief minister. So if I were to look at the analyze the impact of this alliance not taking place across Goa, do you think it will help BJP chances?
No, we could have become more stronger. That's what I feel. If we could have been able to rope in everybody.
And okay, fine. I mean, I was speaking to Sadhya Sai. He is confident that out of five, you know, he will win all four, and then he's got support from one or two more. And together, you people should be able to form the government. Looking at the BJPs, there is clearly you know, sort of anti-incumbency against the BJP. But is that enough for BJP to lose power, given that, you know, Manohar Parrikar has been camping here, you know, for so long? He's a very popular leader in Goa.
No, you must go into the details as to why people are annoyed with the BJP government. See, BJP government came to power 5 years back by painting us black. Our government's performance was very good. We had won all the elections till the general elections. We had won municipal elections. My government had our government has performed. Whatever by-elections we had, we won the by-election. Whether it is assembly poll, Lok Sabha poll, we won the 2009 parliament election also from South Goa. Municipal election, panchayat elections were all swept by the Congress party. But unfortunately, BJP tried to paint us black. And they assured the people something which was not possible. And which was very difficult. It is like just, I will get you moon, I will get you sun, and all these type of promises. Now, they have not fulfilled any of those promises till today. And that is why this government is known as the government of U-turns.
Even here in state, because in Delhi they are often being accused of, you know.
See, I'll give you an example. My government had prepared a regional plan 2021. We got involved eminent world famous architect Charles Kudela. The plan was prepared under the guidance of Mr. Charles Kudela. They said this is a big racket. They said that the moment you bring my government to power, they said we will scrap the regional plan. Now 5 years have passed. They have not scrapped the regional.
They haven't, okay.
And now they are saying that the plan was quite good. We will slightly modify it. That means you informed wrongly to the people. They said that they will make zero VAT on petrol. Immediately they came to power, within 15 days, they brought the VAT on the petrol to 0%. What is the state of affairs today? Today the VAT has again gone to 20%. Okay. What happens to your assurance to the people? You have used them. You have fooled the people by giving some assurances. They said you will give 50,000 jobs to the people. You said you will give unemployment allowance of 4,500. Has any boy or girl in the state of Goa has got unemployment allowance of 4,000 or 4,500? You can ask any boy or girl. Just see.
One of the things that really dogged you, you know, in the last few years was your name surfacing in Louis Berger case. What's the status of that case now?
See, Louis Berger case is a framed case to take some vindictive action against me. They wanted
by whom?
By the ruling government, by the BJP government. Probably, I do not know, but there many people are involved in it. See,
including Manohar Parrikar?
Including him, 100%. There is no doubt about it. See, the case was framed, you can make out, there is not a single place where my name is figuring. Mm-hmm. Somebody sent some email to one of the officers of the Louis Bergeron, produces in the court, which says that they have given some money to a minister and officials of the PWD to secure some contract. This company was defrauded by their top executives. Okay. To save their life, probably in the court they must be saying that they have paid this much money here, this much money there, this much money there. But the main thing is that on the basis of that some email, they file a case against a minister. I was not a minister at that time. I was the chief minister of the state. Mm. And then they catch hold of some ex-employees, bring them, take their statement, saying that they have given some money to me also and some money to PWD minister. They don't arrest them. They leave them just like that. Mm-hmm. They bring other people's top executive. They're one of the partner comes. They're one of the, this fellow comes, country head comes and tells them, they force them to give statements. They tell them that we have nothing to do with this project. We have no this in this. So all the statements even which are recorded.
So your name is not mentioned anywhere.
My name is not only that, I bet. Even if that file has come to me, there is no signature of mine on any of those.
Was it supposed to have come to you as the chief minister? Did you need to sign that file?
I did not need to sign that file.
Okay.
Because any JICA project is governed by Japan Bank of Cooperation. All the guidelines you have to follow of this bank. Every level, even before issuing the tender document, the tender document has to be approved by the Japan Bank.
Right.
So there is no involvement of chief minister's office, because ultimately if chief minister gets the file, he gets it through under secretary finance, secretary finance. That is a system by which files are routed. It doesn't come to me directly.
Okay. So what's the status now? I mean, are you...
The matter is in the court now.
Has that affected the public perception?
After this, see, that's what I said. People of Margao especially know me from my childhood.
Correct.
I was born in Margao. I will die in Margao, and people know my background. People know the background of my family. So I tell them that my father had given me a car, gifted me a car when I completed 18 years. I was one of the three or four students in the Chogle College when I used to go in car. So that has been my status in Margao. So people of Margao know me. They know me in and out, and that is why they don't fall to any such type of gimmicks. Otherwise, they would not have given municipal council in our hands. After this, I faced municipal polls. I could not campaign properly because the matter that time was going on in the court. Just 10 days before the municipal polls, High Court rejected their petition where they have opposed my anticipation. Then they filed it in the Supreme Court. Now, last 2 years, matter is in the Supreme Court.
So, after the elections, what is your prediction? I mean, are you really confident about forming a government, you know, with your like-minded partners? Or do you think, you know...
I think, by and large, in Goa, one thing is very clear. People of Goa do not want this government to come back to power again. Because this government has failed miserably on all the fronts. They were talking of zero tolerance in corruption. These people have not left even garbage. They have made money on garbage. Garbage collecting scheme, beach cleaning scheme is a biggest scam. My government had given works for 80 lakhs and 90 lakhs in South Goa and North Goa, which works out to 1.70 crores for cleaning up the beaches manually. These people said they will use mechanized things, and they gave the same works for 14 crores on both the beaches.
The Manohar Parikar yesterday said that, you know, when he took over, the state was under 25,000 crore debt, and how he got over should be made a case study
He has a habit of throwing the figures on the one person's face, because people do not know, they do not check, they never check the figures. No, normally common man doesn't check the figures. See, my government's performance during the 5 years period was the, today people are comparing. Today, people are comparing my government performance vis-a-vis the BJP performance. See, you go to Panjim and see. While going from Margao, near the collectorate, you see the collectorate building. That was my government's creation.
Okay.
You see the, just after the collectorate, there's a building which has come up and just kept pending there. It is a district hospital which I started for the people, poor people of South Goa. because health is becoming very expensive. For 5 years they have kept that building just like that without completing, and they are completing third Mandovi bridge. There are two bridges on the Mandovi river, and they are doing it third bridge on the Mandovi. They have dug the hot mix road from Miramar to Dona Paula, which was hot mixed just 6 months before, and they are trying to convert into a concrete road. These are the few examples.
But then how will you form government when there are too many stakeholders? There is no unity, unlike Bihar. You know, how the classic case of Bihar was that all the non-BJP parties came together on one platform. That hasn't happened, even though Goa is a small state. You know, you have yourself, Vijay Sarda Sai's party, Aam Aadmi party. These are the three kind of like eating into each other's votes.
I feel this time people will vote for a stability. People have experienced this government's performance for the 5 years. And I'm 100% sure they will go for a stable government. They will not like to damage, the social fiber which exists in the state of Goa. Because of various reasons, we have a total communal harmony in this state.
Yes.
If you go today, anywhere, during Eid, we never used to cook at home. During Christmas, we never used to cook at home. We go to other places, other houses to eat.
Yeah.
And on Diwali day, all people come to my house. So this has been the tradition of Goa.
And your house is next to a mosque.
I'm staying
in the mosque building, actually.
A chief minister of a state, staying next to masjid, I can bet if there is any example
actually,
in the entire
this
country.
Is amazing. I coming from North India, I think the people should realize that. And I had noticed long ago when I first got married, Mr. Kama's official residence where we are sitting right now, it's a kind of the building that shares the wall with the mosque.
Exactly.
You know, that's close it is. Yes. Sir.
So if there is a nail is hit from that side, it will enter my bedroom.
Yeah.
So that sort of, even when I was a chief minister, police came and said that they would like to block this road and create some these, and I said
blocked.
Nothing.
No, it was never
I said
blocked.
Nothing. I said it was on Friday they have prayer meeting.
Yeah.
I have been staying here for the last. I came here in 1982. Since then I have been staying here. So I said let my access to the common man should not be blocked under the name that I have become chief minister.
And
this has been my speciality.
And you are not an atheist. You are a very practicing Brahmin.
I'm a strong believer in God.
Correct. Correct. Absolutely.
But I know to respect the other's religion. My religion teaches me that you shall respect the other's
religion. Being religious doesn't mean being communal. I mean, let's put it this way.
I agree with
you. On 11th of March, what's your prediction? How are you seeing the seat-wise?
No, I feel people of Goa will vote against the existing ruling dispensation.
No, I'm saying, will you be able to achieve majority on your own, or do you think...
The effort will be there to achieve majority on own, but even if there is some shortage, I'm sure people will not go towards BJP.
Towards BJP. You should be able to form government with like
Congress will be able to form the government. That's what
and
I
Congress will be the leading partner. That's what you're
predicting. Yeah, Congress will be the leading partner. Okay. Otherwise also.
So you've got 30 seconds. You have to speak to, you know, your constituency in Margaon and across Goa and the people, Goan people living abroad. Why people should vote for you in particular and your party in general?
I have performed during my last 22 years as the MLA of Margaon. My relationship, my accessibility to a common man in the state of Margaon, and not only in the state of Margaon, in entire Goa is well known. People respect me because of that factor. I probably was the only chief minister who would pick up his mobile number whenever there is to be a call. Even today, my number remains the same for the last 22 years. There is no change. I have not changed my number. And today, if somebody calls me, I respond immediately. Or if I am busy, I will call him back. This has been my speciality. People of Margaon and people of Goa know this. And they feel that in any emergency, in any distress, there is one house whose door will be always open to them, is the house of Digambar Kamat. This is the perception in Margaon and in Goa.
Thank you very much, Mr. Kamat. It was lovely speaking to you. And to you people, you know, our next destination is we are going to speak to different leaders. Our next stopover would be in Panji, where we will try and get hold of the leader from Aam Aadmi Party and the BJP. You know, that's most important. So let's see how it goes. We'll keep you updated. Till then, have a great day.